Hey, everybody. This is LaDondra Hervey, your soul alignment business coach. I'm excited today because we're going to start this video off gigging a bit. We're going to gig to, I ain't going to tell you. It's a surprise. Let me see. I hope you can hear this. I hope you can hear that. We're gonna gig out for a second. There's a purpose for it. Yes. Hey. Yeah. Yeah, this the OJ's, guys, for the love of money. Yeah. Okay, guys, I wanted to start with that. That is For the Love of Money by the OJ's. That is from the famous movie New Jack City. Love it. Now, for me, my husband, he has this as his ringtone on his phone, For the Love of Money, and he's been having this on his ringtone for like some years now, and it gets on my nerves when it rings because it come in all loud and everything. But it's crazy because God dropped a message in my spirit about this just the other day, and it was relating to, is money your master or is it your servant in your business? Now, this lesson, this applies to your life and your business. So wherever you are, you know, just take the lessons for what it is and for what you need it for. But I played that song by intention because there were some really good things from that I want to debrief with you. I'm looking for my thing. When you saw the move, when you heard the song, it says, for the love of money, some people got to have it. Some people, they need it. Some people do bad things. Some people do good things. Some people, they will steal from their mother. They will sell out their own brother. They don't care. They will drive some people out of their mind. They will even sell their soul for the love of money. In these instances, money has become the master of the person who possesses it. In these instances, money has become the master of the person who possesses it. Now, from my interpretation of the Bible, it says that we should be the head and not the tail. We should be the ruler. Money shouldn't rule us. We should rule it. We should tell it where to go, and it shouldn't tell us where to go and what to do. Okay? So today, we're going to talk about that. I'm going to talk about some of the lessons that I received, and you're going to see me coming straight from my journal, because what I feel is that there's about to be a shift. There's been some people who have been struggling. We've been talking a lot about discouragement, and there's been a lot of people who've been struggling, and money has been one of those issues. It's been driving their decisions. It's been driving them into anxiety. It's been driving them into a place of depression. It has taken control. It has become their master. Yes, don't feel condemned about this. You should not feel any condemnation about it. Yet, you should take this and apply it where you need it the most. Use this message as a message of encouragement. Because what I feel is that there's about to be a shift in the atmosphere. God is about to do some big things in some people's lives who have been waiting. Who have been waiting and doing the work in the process. And while they have been waiting, they have reached a place of discouragement. Well, I in my meditation and prayer time, I have felt a shift that's about to occur. But before you can take part of that shift, you're going to have to shift some things in your mind so that you can move from a place that money is no longer your master, but it's a servant. It's doing the role of a servant, which is what it's supposed to do. So you will know that money is your master when it controls your atmosphere. Yes, when it controls your atmosphere, that means it's controlling your attitude, it's controlling your energy, it is literally controlling and setting the pace of your atmosphere. Yes, I'm pausing because I want you to take that in. If you're showing up, you're stressed all the time, you're feeling worried, you're feeling doubt, you're feeling like you don't know what's next, and your energy is drained, you're depressed, you're anxious, you have all these feelings, that means that money is starting to control your atmosphere, and now it is mastering you instead of you mastering it. You'll know when money has become a master in your life or your business is when it controls your altitude. Yes, your altitude. That means how high you will go in your life, your business, in achieving your goals. So if you're basing your circumstances, your dreams around your circumstances, money has become your master. Because you're no longer in control. It's controlling your destination. It has controlled your vision, and it's telling you what you should and should not do. But the opposite should be true. Your money, you should be telling your money what it's about to do for you and how it can serve you in your vision and how it can serve you in your goals and how it can serve you in accomplishing things. Will it all show up at one time? Absolutely not. But the word says, write the vision, make it plain. As you write that vision and you make it plain, then the dollars that you create should be serving you in your business. It should not be mastering you. It should not be telling you what you should and should not do. It also, you'll know if it's directing your altitude, if it's directing the story, you allow it to direct your story you tell yourself about your now. So if you're telling yourself right now, I'm broke, I'm never gonna get anywhere, my life situation, these are the cards of what I'm dealt, I never have good luck, all things are always against me, why me? Woe is me story is going on. When you have that plan in your head and you have that woe is me story happening, that means money has become a master for you, because you should be in control of the conversation of your money story, regardless of where you are right now. Your vision may not, as my good friend Donna posted this morning, your vision may not line up with your circumstances. That's okay, but you shouldn't allow the story that you tell yourself to dictate the actions that you're taking. And that is actually one of the things there. Negativity informs your daily decisions. So how you show up in the marketplace, how you're valuing yourself, how your sales conversations are going on. Because you're putting out an energy that is that's not attracting the people that you're called to serve. And you've put yourself in a place where you have plateaued. Your money situation should not control your altitude. You are in control of your altitude, how far, how high you will go, how far you will soar, how high you will go up. Your circumstances should not dictate that. So this is a mindset shift. And this is a mindset shift that you're no longer in a place of lack, because God has created you to be an abundant creator, an abundant creator. So will you have everything all at once? Absolutely not. But if you start positioning yourself from a place where you're thinking from a place of lack, that I just don't have, I don't have this, and wealth is for the rich, and all these different things that come up, and all I'm going to be good for is just working my 8 to 5 and making the minimum wage, and I've only made this amount of money thus far. Guys, that's a lie. That is a lie. You are more than that. Yes, that's where you've been, but it doesn't have to be where you continue to go. That's why it's going to be important that you create a plan that aligns with the altitude that you're trying to reach. Okay? You have to create a plan that aligns with the altitude that you're trying to reach. So, for example, if the plane chooses, the pilot doesn't know the altitude that it's going to go, then it never can position itself to go in that direction. It's not going to reach the height that it needs to reach in order for it to soar and fly at the level and the capacity that it needs to fly in order to sustain it. The same is true for you. If you don't know the altitude that you're supposed to go, then you're never going to position yourself according to the vision that you need to, and you're going to continue to allow your money story to dictate where you're going, how far you go, the directions that you go, the people that you meet, and the people that you attract. Okay? So that's another reason how you know money has become your master. The third reason is when it controls your actions. Yes. So when it controls your actions, that goes with the decisions that you're making, or you're soaking in sorrow or pursuing and not pursuing a solution. So you're still sitting there like, woe is me. Like, this is my story. And you're just there. You're binge watching on Netflix. You're watching other people get success. You feel like success is only for a certain group of people. And you stop allowing yourself to pursue a solution or to seek out a solution when the solution is within you. There are solutions within you, but you've defeated yourself mentally because you've allowed your money story to dictate where you're going, and you've allowed your money story to dictate your actions. So now you have defeated yourself, and you're just sitting on the couch, or you're just going through to your job, or you just going through the motions in your business, and you're not pursuing at the level that you need to. You're trying to figure it out on your own, and you're not seeking help. Help is there. The help is there for you. So if you found yourself in a place where you've plateaued, you've done all you can, you feel like you've showed up. You feel like you've showed up, but nothing is showing up for you. Maybe it's something that you're doing wrong. Maybe it's how you're showing up. There's a quote. Let me see if I can find this quote in this book. It's from The Millions Within. I had highlighted this. It's really because he says something that I really like. It says, who you really are can easily be confused with who you are being at any moment in time, how you are acting, what you are thinking, and what you're doing. So what that says is that it's really, a lot of times we think that success is in our doing. Our money is in our doing, but it's really in how we are being, how we're showing up, the decisions that we're making, how we're presenting ourselves. Because like attracts like. And so if you are thinking of yourself lowly, or you're thinking of yourself with low value, then that's what you're going to attract into your life. If your money story is telling you that you are worthless, guess what? You're going to attract worthless situations. So you got to get back in control by the actions that you take. So the thoughts you think first, and then whatever thought you think is going to determine an action for you. Let's see. So another thing is in your actions. So when it controls your actions, then you're spending money that you don't have to appear successful. A lot of times we're spending money to look the part, but really we're not that part. Now there's a difference. There's a difference in positioning yourself to look good, to feel good, to be good. But there's a whole different thing if you're doing it to perform and please, and to try to fit in and all of that stuff. Your decision, when you do that, your decisions is not in alignment with what your true vision is, because you're trying to make something be that is not. And so now your money is controlling you, and you're not in control of it. It's telling you you have to do a certain thing in order to amass success, which is a lie, because you should be telling it what you're going to do and how you're going to show up and the decisions that you're going to make. Okay? You need to be telling it. It needs to serve you in the directions that you want to go to. Let's see. Or you are not paying another action that may be showing up. Let me see. Another action that may be showing up is you're not paying attention to what's coming in or going out. You have gotten dismissive. You are dismissive. So you're not paying attention to your money. You feel defeated. So now you're not paying attention to what's going in. You're not paying attention to what's coming out. You're not even worried about it. You're not worried about it. It's kind of like you nonchalant about the situation. And you know that it's kind of, it's bothering you. It's bothering you. But subconsciously, you feel like you're defeated. So you're just not going to worry about it. Well, guess what? That's when you know that money has become your master in your actions, because again, you should be in control of that. So one of the things that I want to tell you in this is that one of the things that has helped me, and this is truly a journey, I feel like it's a journey that we are all on, because it doesn't matter if you've got success now. It doesn't matter if you don't have success. It doesn't matter if you've plateaued. It does not matter. What matters is that you get back into control. And one of the things that has helped me is that making sure that I put myself in a place to where I'm consistently hearing from God. Because what I know is that God is the source of all things, right? So that includes your money, the money that you have coming into your household, whether it's a lot or it's a little, whatever. But you need to make sure that you always decrease and go to the source and ask God, what do He want for your money? What are the ideas? What are some creative ways that He can help you to get more money? What is the way? Because one of the things that I know, according to the Bible, is with the richest man in the world, Solomon, he did not seek out. He didn't pray for riches. He prayed for wisdom. And with him praying for wisdom, then he became the richest man in the world. Maybe the same needs to be true for us. We need to pray for wisdom to get wealth. And maybe we need to stop toiling around for it so much, and maybe we need to get ourselves in a position to receive the wealth that has been promised to us. Proverbs 10:22 tells us that the blessing of the Lord makes a person rich, and He adds no sorrow with it. That's the New Living Translation. There's another translation, because I got them both in here. The blessing of the Lord brings wealth without painful toil to it. That is Proverbs 10:22, but it's the NIV version. The blessing of the Lord. So you need to go to the Lord, seek some wisdom. And it's different. There's a difference between just being on your knees, but then also and not getting up and doing anything with it. Because that's a sign of disobedience. Whatever you receive. So if you're praying for wisdom to get wealth, or you're praying for wisdom to increase your income in your business, or you're praying for wisdom to increase your income just period in your household, if God gives you an idea, He gives you a vision, don't second guess it. Don't doubt your abilities to do it. Get up and go do it. If you don't know what to do, seek help. Seek help from a trusted advisor. Seek help from somebody that's near you that you know that you can trust. Not just somebody that's saying something, but somebody who's walking the walk. That makes a whole big difference in things. Okay, so, and if you don't know no one, I would love to be a source for you, a source to talk things through with you, a source to coach you through some things, because there are some certain mindsets that you need to embrace in order to get on track to pursuing things. It's not about getting another strategy, and it's not getting another strategy. It's about positioning yourself to become more of who God is calling you to be, become more of the person that He's calling you to be, because when you become the person that He's calling you to be, then the other things will be added to you. But if you're study ignoring the person, trying to be something else or doing whatever you feel like you need to do in order to get riches or to get wealth, then you're never going to get there. You're going to keep going around and around and around the same mountain over and over and never getting to the promised land. It's time out for that. It's time to get to your promised land. Will there be a process? Absolutely. And the process doesn't feel good, but don't allow the process to deter you from getting to the promise, because you have to have faith enough to know that you will get to the promise. In order to get to the promise, you have to put things in it to prioritize the things in your life. And that includes your money mindset. That means getting into a place where money is no longer your master, but it's your servant. It's serving you according to your vision. It's serving you according to the plans that God has laid on your heart. It's serving you. You're not serving it. So I just want to end with this. Be encouraged. No matter how hard it gets, stay encouraged. Because the best can be yours if you allow it to be. I had mentioned a free resource that I had for you guys yesterday because I'm about first becoming the person that God has called you to be, really embracing your identity first, and then start to strategize from there. But you can't in your life and business, but you can't get there until you can clear some things, some internal things that's keeping you from stepping up into your calling and purpose. So I'll post the link for that. For you to take advantage of that, that is absolutely free, but it's only effective as the work that you put into it. So you got to show up and you got to do the work. Yes, you will be doing that work. That's you and your alone time. It's going to be that time where you got to look in the mirror, and there may be some uncute things that you see in the mirror, but what happens is if you walk through the process, there's beauty on the other side. I promise you, there's beauty on the other side. God gives you beauty for ashes. So go on and burn them ashes so you can embrace the beauty of your God-given calling and step into your purpose. I'm going to be talking a little bit more about money tomorrow. So I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. And if this has been provided any value to you, please share it. Don't grow alone. Don't hoard this information, because there's a lot of bad information out there. And there's just a lot of information that's telling you, you can, you can, you can. But then they're not telling you that before you can, you have to become. You got to clear up that past negative energy that's keeping you from pursuing your God-given purpose. You got to clear up those hurts. You got to clear up those hangups. You got to clear up those old mindsets that's not serving you. So like I said, share it. I'll put that free resource in the thing, and until tomorrow, y'all have a blessed day. All right, bye-bye.